I think that like pop is definitely going to be like things like Mariah Carey and Michael Bolton and really mainstream kind of stuff. I think that to people, alternative means different. It's not the norm. It's kind of different for some reason. It's different than the norm. So we got the alternative label because we were different than the norm. Obviously, we're an Irish band and, you know, there's like a lot of, like there's accent and the music isn't exactly always pop. I mean, sometimes you can write a song that has a kind of a very poppy beat, and then you can write something that's very
rocky,
and then you can write something that's totally like a Dead March or something, you know. So to the Cranberries, there are no limits with sounds or, you know, musical influences, you know. So it's, I think it's kind of hard to label this band.
I'd like to talk about Free to Decide. It's going to be the next single after Salvation. There's a line in that song which says, and I'm not so suicidal after all, and it's kind of struck me. Melodically, it's beautiful, and it's still, at the same time, the message is like, where did you get that?
I probably got it from the, like, certain annoying media people asking me all the time when I was going to do it, like, kind of thing, you know? It's like people just are strange, you know, and it's like there are some people that are fine and that, you know, treat you normally, and then there's just like a lot of people that are kind of, I mean, I remember at one particular point there was like a couple of press releases saying that I was really depressed and blah blah blah, and I hated my fame, and so did Sinead O'Connor, and so did all these other Irish artists, and we were all depressant and all this kind of stuff, and it was like, it's just annoying, like, so it was just a retaliation to some stupid media, some bad press, you know.
This is our current single.
Makes a good song.
It has to be like a genuine, something really genuine in it, a genuine emotion, and the music has to be inspiring. So that's basically it, you know, a message, inspiring music, and a vibe.
Yeah. course, and all right, totally different, I think.
Yeah, it's like a Zombies one that I did alone. And the stuff I think that me and Noel do together is usually kind of more melodious or something.
Mm.
And when I do stuff, it's always more rhythmic.
Rhythmic, yeah, definitely.
Because when I'm kind of writing, I tend to kind of go 1, 2, 3, 4, you know, like that. Because your melody is coming out of here and your mouth, so you're not getting too melodious on the guitar, you know. So it's always more rhythmic, which is good, because then when me and Noel do stuff together, it's really different, like Linger and Ode to My Family. You know, they're always like songs that you can really write string sections to.
Mm-hmm.
I want to talk about your voice. What are the comments you usually get about your voice?
They vary from like unique, ethereal, cosmic man. It's just like an endless list of, you know, kind of weird words people use to describe it. But people say that it's very unique. Dreaming my dreams. There are numerous bad memories and stuff, but I mean, if you want to move on and be a good artist and be a happy human being, you have to bury the shit and look to the future. Yeah. So we kind of choose to bury the crap, and once you bury it, you don't talk about it anymore, you know, it's gone, it's history, it's like if somebody died, it's like you're not going to go around talking about them all the time because, you know, you want to forget about the heavy stuff and you want to look forward to the bright stuff. It is a very, like, extreme business. there are very high moments for a rock star and very low moments, but basically it's like you think to the high moments, so you think to the fans and you think to the rewards, you know, as opposed to the depressing stuff.
Yeah.
Because you only get depressed if you start thinking about that, you know. This is one of our older songs. It's a song, kind of a sad song, called The Icicle Melts. Basically, people come to see our shows every night and people look like they're happy with what they see. But at the same time, I mean, we have no, like, large floating objects on the stage, like silver bombs or anything. It's just a real four-people gig. It's very real, down-to-earth thing, you know? And there's no, like, samples and there's no backing singers. Yeah. It's just the four of us, you know? So we don't worry about hype because we know that we're not creating something that we're not in control of.
Yeah.
It's just sounds and we're just playing and that's it, you know? Are you guys ready to shake some butt? Yeah, yeah. The way you want it, oh, oh, I don't understand. What's happened with me is that I've reached that level in my head where I kind of find it all very funny now, so sometimes you start playing up to whatever you're doing, you really play to it, you know. Whereas, you know, when I started singing, I stood like a statue on stage for about a year and a half to 2 years, and people used to kind of label me as the girl who stood sideways, the English Prestige, you know. And everybody used to laugh at me and stuff. And now it's at that point where you're like, it's all so, like, unbelievable the way it's happened so quickly. So you're on stage and you're like, woohoo, you think this is a big movie or something. So you're just really playing the role and you get really into it. Like, you don't, like, you don't take it seriously. or a zombie?
Well, the song was inspired by a child's death. His life was taken in the arms of his mother. She was out shopping in London last year, and there was a bomb planted in a rubbish bin in London. And he happened to be in the wrong place at the wrong time, and he died. And the reason that the bomb was planted was because of a political, territorial kind of thing that goes on between the north of Ireland and the UK. So the references to 1916 would be that in 1916, that was when the contract was signed away the six counties to England, and it still goes on, the war and the deaths and the injustice.
I may take this moment to be, excuse all these cameras, because I think we're making a video. So you guys, you can be in our video, so we're all gonna be famous together, woo! So we're gonna leave you guys with this song. Thanks a million for coming along. Hope you enjoy the concert, all right?
Thank you.
there a flip side to being a cranberry?
Yeah, I suppose the worst part is that you can never switch it off. Uh-huh. You can never switch off who you are as a celebrity kind of thing. So you're never really guaranteed utter going back to who you used to be before you became a cranberry type thing.
This is also one of the new songs. This is a song, How the Grass Always Seems Greener on the Other Side. When you get there, you want to go back to where you came from, maybe. Maybe. This is called Not Hollywood.